Hello, and welcome back to my Launch Complex's stream of RP1. So, managed to make it to Molnir orbit. What else do I want to... that for? I guess we'll use... a tundra. Kick motor on it. Let's see, so the example tundra orbit. Has an eccentricity of 177. Try to figure out what the appropriate orbit will be. SMA is 421. see. There is. All right. Now, how much of a kick do we need to get to 55? This is. Thirty-two, 34 meters per second. Oof. That's expensive. Wonder why it's so expensive. That's more than like. That's more than it costs to go to the moon. That can't be right. That cannot be right. Oh, I have a typo, I think. Oh, I know what's going on. Think the SMA is including Earth's. It wasn't that, it's that, this makes much more sense. Yeah, 2638 meters per second. Now, how much does it cost? Will it cost to raise? Yeah, so we're at about. Meters per second, I guess. Yeah, I was on my web browser calculator looking at orbital mechanics calculations to figure out how much delta V I need. Answer is lot. The transfer is a little over 7.5 hours. So we need this. The reason we need this is because we're going to need to burn. Stage. That's interesting. We can't do that. Okay. It's interesting. Trying to figure out the answer here, and nothing is coming to mind because I don't actually know how much delta V I'm going to need. Which means I can't really go ahead and use a solid for it. It's a tundra orbit. So, Squirrel, do you know offhand what apogee kick you need for tundra orbit? Because I don't. Sec, let me ponder. Get away with using that stage. I mean, the alternative is to have a much more eccentric tundra orbit, which means we put much more of the delta V burden on the transfer stage and less burden on the circular. So yeah, I could do the extreme version of a tundra orbit that it talks about in the contract, which is 1,000 kilometers by 70,000 kilometers. Yeah, tundra is a one-day period. Which I guess I can just do. Like, it's going to be super cheap to raise perigee at apogee in that case. Yeah, I guess I can just go ahead and do that. Yeah, exactly. Squirrel, you're do I have not been able to find a calculator that will give me an arbitrary change. Basically, all the calculators that I've found assume Hohmann transfers that circularize in the end. And I want something that will go from an arbitrary perigee and apogee to another arbitrary pair of perigee and apogee using two Bernes. So I'll probably have to just actually use the mechanics equations rather than the use the general case instead of the special the simple case. Oh, I know how I can figure this out. Yes, I know how I can figure this out. I know how much. I know. I know the transfer orbit final velocity to apogee. Then I need to know what the orbital energy is for a larger SMA, which then will give me the. I had this idea a second ago. Oh, yes, that's how. Because I know how much it costs to go from an elliptical orbit with the final parameters to a circular orbit. Yes, that will tell me how to that will tell me what I need to know. All right, so the initial velocity in low Earth orbit all right, so we raise, which is equivalent, which is exactly equivalent to lowering. So it's 550 meters per second less than fully circularizing. So it costs 900 meters per second. Cool. Math. So, Squirrel, that's fine, all well and good if you're using liquid. If you're using solid, over-provisioning is a bad idea. For fairly obvious reasons. Oh, I hate that. It's not through blocked. Now we want something about 800 meters. So, oop, that's an altar. This thing. Because it's light. Now I do want 2 to 1. Okay. Okay, hopefully that will be okay. Okay, this will work. Assuming I still have enough Delta V for the energy kick, which I assume I do, but let's find out. Oh, yeah, tons and tons and tons. Okay, this will do. Got to recalculate. Those numbers changed. Yeah, that's a little closer, but I think we're still fine. Should be fine. Lost a little bit of build progress, but not. First tundra satellite, we can do this. Okay, I guess we can make an operational nav system we're thinking about. Although, do these first, because they pay 60K each. Which is about the same that this pays per satellite. Oh no, they pay 60K each. That pays way better than this does per satellite. Yeah, this only pays 250. It should pay 300. Wow, we also need to this a couple more times. Lock better comm satellite contracts. This and the okay, and we need to fly one more regular ComSat contract, unlock the GEO contracts. Com 2. Okay, 64 days for you. That's pretty good. C-19 will come online then. And we can fly a test flight with Mercury. Fly Mercury. Oh God, is that going to take a lot of engineers? I think I can. Slow that down a little bit. All right, that's looking much. Okay. Now we'll churn these out pretty fast. It's got 23 days left. Do it in this order. Got 60 days left. Yeah, sounds good to me. Idea being, we fly these two, and it'll be just in time to start mass producing EO commsats. Second FSAT. Alright, do 900. It's 70 degree inclination. Sure, we'll fly over the eastern seaboard. What could possibly go wrong? How did it have 100 G's acceleration? That's weird. Oh, I forgot to. I forgot to fix using attach altitude for this. Oh. Well, at least it wasn't a fatal failure. Notice. We didn't lose any specific pulse, which is weak. It's pressure fed. I'm sure that failure makes sense. Remember, Ferrum's opinion is that the only failure that matters is engine explodes. Shouldn't even try to model other failures. Six minutes. Okay, seems fine. Go. Why did it underburn so badly? Okay, close enough. Wait a minute. What's going on here? Why is this not completing? Oh, what? Second gen NavSat requires CompSat payload? That's interesting. Totally missed that. Well, given how much spare delta V we have, I'm just Alex, I don't believe that Like test light does do that, I think. I don't think test flight does. Very strange. Oh, I remember some discussion about that. That's interesting. That cost a bunch of delta V, but given how much delta V we have, I don't care. Yeah, I totally missed that the contract said it in the description. Right there. Oh, it's red, which I have trouble against that background. All right, let's fly our Tundra mission, I guess. And how far out are we from fly 9820? Then it'll take probably 90 days or more to build. Then another 90 days for the operational mission, because I want to fly a test flight first. The last suborbital contract, and not suborbital, re-entry contract. So early 1960. Yeah, okay. I guess we might as well accept this. Alex, it does. The density of NavSat payload versus CompSat payload are different. And that's based on the early nav satellites being of a specific size given their mass, and so a specific density, and then the later NavSats basically being heavier for their unit mass, for their unit volume. Thus, CompSat payload fitting the spec step better. I'm not sure that really adds much in terms of gameplay, though. In fact, honestly, we probably should just go to satellite payload as a resource, because I don't think that varying densities make a whole lot of difference. And we now have a good bunch of money. All right, let's fly our Tundra mission. To roll out. Okay, that's still transmitting. All right, Pioneer 2 has completed its experiments. Same with Pioneer 1. Go ahead and get rid of them. Oh yeah, we're in ECI, aren't we? All right, let's switch this over to going into space low over the moon. At some point, we'll get comms. course, it's on the wrong side of the moon. One hour and 15 minutes. Okay. Okay, let's perform that maneuver. hope that we don't get perturbed too badly by the moon. Okay, plenty of power. Okay, we'll let that collect lunar science. Hopefully it doesn't go boom. I think that will do me for tonight. Thanks everyone for watching. See you next time. Bye.